There's the start list for the men's 200 IM, the para. And in lane four, one of the very best in this discipline in the world, Benoit Cuat.
Lane one, representing the Windskill Dolphins, Dalton Boone. In lane number two, representing the Surrey Knights themselves, Adam Rare. Lane three, representing Natacion Para Performance, Isaac Boatley. Lane five, representing the St. Thomas Jumbo Jets, Gordy Mitchie. The main lane number six, representing Club de Tasson, Region de Quebec, Nicolas P. Kirby. The lane seven, representing Club de Tasson, Hop Richelieu, Maxime Rousset.
This is going to be such an exciting race. This is one of Benoit's specialty events. He had disappointing 2008 and came back really strong in 2012, setting a world record and getting the gold medal in this very event. So this is going to be a special one for him.
Silver and gold at the last two world championships in the 200 IM.
And here we're seeing in lane five, Gordy Mitchie. He had the gold medal in the 200 meter freestyle. He's going to be a strong contender here tonight.
He did 2:19.46 in the heats. And that's under the standard of 2:20.78.
But just because he said it this morning doesn't mean that it's getting him to Rio. He needs to do it again tonight. That standard is 2:19.46.
This is the Para Men's 200 IM, 50 meters of butterfly, 50 meters of backstroke, 50 abreast, and they finish with 50 meters of freestyle. Benoit Cuat, an S10, is in lane four. 19 medals for Benoit at the Paralympic Games, one of the living legends in the sport.
He really is a living legend and such a leader of Paralympic sport across the board. He was the flag bearer at the closing ceremonies of London 2012. He is so well respected by so many of his teammates in many different sports.
Cuat, the leader, as we expected, Michi and Isaac Buckley, who is swimming in lane three, also in the S10, silver in the 100 breast and bronze in the 400 free at the Toronto Parapans.
As we can see, Benoit is pulling away from the crowd here, but backstroke is one of his best strokes. Breaststroke is a little bit weaker, so it'll be interesting to see on the next length if anyone can catch up to him.
Benoit will touch first. Turnover and do 50 meters of breaststroke. What kind of a breaststroker is it?
Benoit struggles with the breaststroke. He has a club foot on one side, so he's really only getting propulsion from his arms. His legs are just stabilizing him. And in breaststroke, legs are huge. You really need to get a good push, but he just can't do that because he doesn't have that simultaneous kick, so he's making up for that with his arms. And I think he's been working on his breaststroke. He looks really strong out there, pulling even further away from the rest of the field.
Cuat is the Canadian record holder in the event, 2:10.01. He did that at the London Paralympics.
He also is a former world record holder in this event, and I know in Rio he's going to be going after that again.
Cuat off the wall, heading home now. Less than 50 meters of freestyle to go on the men's 200 IM.
All the athletes are going to be feeling so much pain at this point. They've just gone through three different strokes, so Ben's going to really be leaning on the crowd to help him get home here.
And he is really opening it up. on Gordy Michi, who is swimming in lane 5. He's in S14, but it's Benoit Huot's race, as we suspected. Less than 5 meters to go. We'll get his time when he touches the wall. 2:14.07 for Benoit Huot in lane 5. Gordy Michi puts in a time of 2:17.80, touches for second. And in lane 3, Isaac Buckley with a time of 2:18.84.
Benoit's going to be really happy with that time. You know, it's a bit off of his best, but for this point in the season, I think he's going to be really happy with that solid time. As you can see, he's in some pain there, shaking his head a bit.
Still got swimmers touching. Zach Zona in lane 0. He's an S8. In the top of your picture, Jean-Michel Lavallier, an S7. Lavallier, 6 medals, including gold in the 200 IM at the Toronto Paris.
And there they're off. The start is really important to get that dolphin kick going. That's going to bring you into the butterfly. The first length that really sets the tone for the rest of the race. Benoit had a strong butterfly, but it was in the backstroke that he really pulled away from the rest of the crowd. He had a great touch, getting right into the breaststroke, a strong underwater pullout. And it's clear he's been working on that breaststroke because he pulled even further ahead of the rest of the crowd as he headed home to win the gold medal. That touch was incredible, keeping his head down, not breathing. The last 5 meters of the race is really important to get in there. But he's shaking his head. I think he's pretty disappointed here.
Well, knowing Benoit, he's so competitive, he probably wanted a better time. His Canadian record time, 2:10.01, and he was 2:14.07. Benoit Huot, first to touch, but he has to settle for silver. Gordy Michi, second to touch, but he gets the gold in the race. Isaac Buckley touches for third, and that is where he will stay. He gets the bronze medal.
So again, each swimmer is racing against their own classifications, world records. And that's how Gordy Michi is coming out with the gold medal.
Gordy Michi, 2:17.80 to win the gold medal in the 200 IM. You're in the same pool as Benoit Huot, but a great race for you, Gordy.
It for sure is. Racing Benoit Huot is really fast, and I'm always glad to race him because he pushes me to the limit, that's for sure.
You're having a great meet here, Gordy. Are you looking forward to perhaps getting to the Rio Paralympic Games?
Yeah, my goal is to make the Team Canada go to Rio, and I just keep swimming hard and, keep swimming against my opponents and just see what the result is,
So far, so good. Congratulations, Gordy Michi.
Thank you very much.